In the introduction of A Clockwork Orange, on a winter night in a dystopian city in the not-too-distant future, 15-year-old Alex and his gang, Pete, Dim, and Georgie, drink stimulant-laced milk at the Corova Milk Bar and plan dirty fun, roaming the streets by night, terrorizing citizens. In the rising action, the next day, Alex skips school and goes instead to a record store for a recording of Beethoven's Ninth Symphony. He entices two 10-year-old girls back to his room and rapes them. When he wakes that evening, he leaves his parents' flat to find his gang waiting. To placate Georgie, Alex agrees to rob an elderly woman's home. The robbery fails, and Alex's gang turns on him, leading to his arrest. 2 years later, Alex is 2 years into his 14-year sentence. When an arrogant new prisoner arrives, Alex beats him to death as punishment for his perversion. The next morning, Alex is chosen as a test subject for an experimental treatment aimed at changing his behavior. Each session of the treatment begins with the injection of a drug. Alex is secured to a chair with electrodes attached to his head and torso. His eyes are held open, and he's forced to watch violent films. He survives the treatment, but he's unable to defend himself against a physical attack and is made ill by the sight of an attractive woman. Returning home, Alex finds a lodger named Joe in his room and is turned out by his parents. He's beaten by Dim and Billy Boy, former gang members, Dim one of his own, who are now police, and by a gang of old men led by one of his former victims. Alex staggers to a vaguely familiar cottage whose owner recognizes him from news reports and takes him in. F. Alexander and his comrades oppose the current government and hope to use Alex as a political weapon. Alex becomes aware that F. Alexander is the man he and his gang attacked and whose wife died of shock after the gang rape. F. Alexander figures this out and, in the climax, locks Alex in a room with classical music until sickness overwhelms him. He leaps from the window, hoping to die. In the falling action, Alex wakes in a hospital where doctors treat his injuries and reverse his conditioning. Alex starts full-time work and forms a new gang, but no longer finds violence compelling or fulfilling. In the resolution, Alex decides to find a wife, marry, and have a child. Essentially, growing up. Alex, his gang of droogs, and the problematic adults who try to reform him are the captivating characters in A Clockwork Orange. Alex is the book's protagonist and first-person narrator. Only 15 when the book starts, Alex is a smart, compelling, deeply flawed narrator who forces readers to see the world through the eyes of a teen who not only acts violently, but enjoys each act of violence greatly. Alex is also the voice through which the author, Anthony Burgess, presents issues of freedom of choice and the authority of the state and the boundaries that exist between them. Pete is the least aggressive member of Alex's gang. A follower, he tries to diffuse the tension between Alex and Georgie. And unlike the others, by the time he's 19, he's left the violent teen culture behind, married, and entered the adult world of work and family. Georgie, like Alex, is violent, ambitious, and smart. Georgie is the gang member who tries to make connections and researches possible targets, as opposed to Alex, who drifts through the night looking for chance opportunities for violence. Georgie's motives differ from Alex's. Alex seeks violence for its own sake and for the enjoyment he gets from it, while Georgie wants to focus on theft and financial gain. Dim is big, strong, and irritating to Alex. His guffawing laugh is insufferable. Dim is not very bright, and Alex thinks of him mainly as enforcing muscle. But he is smart enough to grasp that Alex treats him as an inferior and quick enough to disable Alex with a lash of his chain across Alex's eyes, betraying him and effectively turning him over to the police. And Dim doesn't change when he becomes a police officer himself. F. Alexander is a foil to Alex. Both characters grasp that the modern state can and sometimes does overstep its boundaries of control over human behavior. Alex's reaction to the idea of A Clockwork Orange is visceral and personal. F. Alexander approaches this concept he's written about intellectually, but fails to apply it personally. Yet F. Alexander also gives Alex the language he needs to consider what the state has done to him. The Minister of the Interior is the very face of the state, the representative of what Alex calls the boastful, vawny, or stinking, government. The minister wants to use Alex for the state's purposes, both as a guinea pig for behavioral therapy and later as a partner in covering the state's mistakes. Music, darkness, nadsat, and milk are the simple symbols with terrifying deeper meaning in A Clockwork Orange. Burgess describes his twisted protagonist as possessing an essential human trait, a love of beauty. For Alex, beauty is found in classical music and especially in the symphonic works of Beethoven, especially his Ninth Symphony, and the final movement, which contains the solo and choral versions of Ode to Joy. Celebrating the common humanity of all people, these movements play important symbolic and ironic roles in the novel. Darkness permeates the novel's settings, which often are either very dark, winter's nights or enclosed clubs, or very bright, as in the blindingly white building where Alex undergoes treatment. Darkness covers Alex's violent actions and hides him from their consequences. When he's in the light, especially bright, sterile light shined on him by the state, he's left vulnerable and even fearful. Burgess's use of NADSAT forces the reader to confront the novel's violence intellectually rather than viscerally, perhaps one of the most significant artistic differences between the novel and the famous film. NADSAT is Alex's idiom, and it helps to create his world and draw readers into it. Once readers become comfortable with the idiom, they are, in a sense, on Alex's side. Milk is the quintessential child's food and is often associated with innocence, healthy growth, and comfort. But milk, as the teens drink it, spiked with hallucinogens or stimulants, becomes a way more complicated drink. When Alex and his gang go out looking for dirty fun, amped up on spiked milk, they do so on a school night. By day, they're still children, still the wards of their parents. By night, they make the streets their domain. Free will, conformity, humanity, and treachery and loyalty are the central themes underscoring Anthony Burgess's infamous novel, A Clockwork Orange. A Clockwork Orange is set in a dystopian world in which the state has great control over people's lives and wants to increase that control. Burgess believed people must be free to choose their beliefs and actions, good or evil. Understanding that people will, for various reasons, choose badly means that forgiveness and reform must always be options as well, again, chosen freely. So people must vigilantly guard their freedom to choose and accept the difficulty of choice itself. Conformity has its place in human interactions. We must cooperate, share some goals, and agree on some values, or we will have difficulty achieving necessary objectives. But the pressure to conform is cultural influence that threatens to abridge free will. The danger comes when patterns of conformity are imposed by the state. People become to the state abstract statistics more easily managed if they comply and conform. In a way, Alex becomes a representative of humanity under assault from institutional forces, particularly the state. Alex, as Burgess writes, is perhaps over-endowed with three essential human traits: an innate enjoyment of language, a love of beauty, and an aggressive nature, symbolic of Freud's concept of the id, the ego, and the superego, the first and third of which are at play in Alex. Alex's experiences chronicle the struggle of an individual to maintain human identity, regardless of the state's desires and demands. Treachery and loyalty is a theme central to Alex as well. He tries to be loyal to Pete, Dim, and Georgie in his smug 15-year-old way. In return, he expects them to be loyal, meaning they have to exercise self-discipline and restraint, even to the point of denying their own nature. Throughout the novel, groups and individuals act in ways that seem to Alex treacherous and disloyal.